Hello everyone, here is Hawk and I'm Helena and we are the candidates in the local elections, and now we thought that we'll discuss the topic about the airport in Joensuu, because now it has been about a year that there hasn't been any air traffic from Joensuu to Helsinki, and what do we think about, should there be this airport function?
Have you used it? Have you ever flown into Joensuu?
To be honest, I have.
Same here.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I have to say that I also have a special life situation where my children are living in Denmark, so I need to travel more than is ecological at the moment. So, but what do you think, Huck? What is your personal opinion about how important it's to have airport in Joensuu, or is it important?
Okay, so when you ask personal opinion, again, I'm trying to take an ecocentric perspective on this, because we more and more understand to solve our global struggles, we need to take on an ecocentric perspective. Well, we have six survival priorities: food, water, air, shelter, health, and community, right? Transportation in vehicles that are heavier than we are is not part of a survival priority. It's something that we can use, it's a tool, but it's not high on the list of priorities. So when we look at this Maslow's pyramid, right?
Yeah.
You have in the bottom, you have like the priorities covered, and then you go and do other stuff,
yeah,
right? We actually are not taking care of the bottom layer very much in the moment. We are, you know, a species in danger of being extinct the way we are doing things in the moment. So I see the whole perspective of like, yes, for business, for tourism, I don't know what else, for convenience, like a satisfaction on technology or something, some utopian dream, I don't know what it is. I can see the fascination with aviation and I see how useful it can be, and also I think that there are certain ways where we can make very wise use of this technology. At the same time, I need to remind myself, this is not our priority. If we suddenly need aviation to get bread, you know, or get food for our family, then something is a bit off.
Yeah, I think that my personal I reflect, of course, to personal experience as well, and now this past year where it has taken considerably longer to get to my children on another country, I still think that it has been manageable to take the train from Joensuu to Helsinki. And actually, one thing that
it's a beautiful journey.
It's a beautiful journey, and one thing that I think that we could take back is the night trains between Joensuu
to
Helsinki.
Buses.
Or night buses,
yes,
as well,
yeah,
but definitely the trains, because I have really good childhood memories of those cabins where there's even beds, and almost like in a Trans-Siberian railway where we went to Helsinki and to Turku as well,
yeah,
by the night train. So I also agree with you that it's not like absolute survival necessity to have the airport. Yet at the same time, of course, being sympathetic for listening the needs of those who find it absolutely necessary. But how do you believe, Huck, that there is the future for the aviation that is like ecologically or energetically somehow non-polluting or something?
Well, for sure we can make non-polluting when we look at the aeroplane itself. Still, the aeroplane itself will be dependent on an infrastructure and a network that is resource heavy and also dependent on fossil resources and fossil energy to some extent. So we will never get that really off the hook. Also, like, really the question in my mind, what is enough? What is need to have? What is nice to have? And really that's you know, it's a tough question, because like when you think of like, you know, having family living abroad, right? We have changed our world that suddenly we cannot stay connected with our families without traveling around the world. So at the same time we have, you know, that's also something to think, we have people in our neighborhoods who don't have families, right? And we have our families abroad, so maybe we need to just reconnect, you know, it's just about our levels of connection with each other. So I really think that the question, like, you know, what can we want? right? Yes, we can do what we want, right? We can build an aeroplane and fly it around and build the airport and use whatever fuel. We can do that, for sure, we can do that. Still, can we really want that? That's the question that I have. And I personally feel that, well, from the environmental perspective and or from the perspective of the natural world and us being members, interdependent members of the natural world, we really cannot want this. And it's maybe inconvenient, it's just a habit that we need to think twice about.
So what is convenient and what we feel inconvenient but still what is ethical and what needs to be done. So thank you for listening this discussion, and you're welcome to join the discussions and debate on these issues if you are interested.
Yes, please comment below or contact us one way or the other, and maybe you want to be a candidate yourself.
Good idea.
Thank you.